Welcome back to my channel, Smoking and Grilling and Cooking with me, AB.
Okay, now we're getting ready to go over the ingredients. Here, I got a pound and a half of, this is 80-20. This right here makes for some good, you know, some good tasting, you know, ground beef. Especially when we're doing a chili, you want your beef to be, you just want your chili to be the best it can be. All right, right here, we got some Rotel. Look, this is that diced tomatoes with green chilies. We got tomato sauce, black beans, kidney beans, and then this was a, you know, just a large yellow onion. I've already diced this. Then we got some cream of corn. This cream of corn is gonna go into cornbread on the top. Now I'm not gonna pull out all the ingredients for the cornbread because you guys can look. I'll leave a link up at the top. I got two different styles of cornbread, both of them delicious. Pick your choice. And listen, if you want to, you can go ahead and use Jiffy or whatever else you want to use to put on the top of this. This right here, we just gonna call this one of them like one pot meals, super easy to make. Now, we got cumin, chili powder, oregano, and minced garlic right here. Now, right here I got kosher salt. And then we gonna grind our pepper, fresh ground pepper. And I'm using olive oil along with this ground beef right here to get it started.
Now, first thing I do is I take my olive oil. Now listen, you got two options here. You can use the olive oil and you wanna saute your onions, you can do that first and then add your ground beef, you know, along with your garlic. That's up to you. I'm gonna do it this way and I wanna show you and then I'm gonna explain to you why. A little olive oil in there first, get my ground beef, start breaking it up with that flat edge, you know, wooden spoon. And after, you know, it starts to brown, it's almost completely brown, I can still see a little pink, then I go ahead and add my onion. Reason being is, I don't want my onions to be soft. You know what I mean? It's up to you though. This is one of the recipes, you make it your own. This right here is just the base. I do it this way and I cook it with the rest of my my spices, you know what I mean? And I let it become translucent here, but it keeps the onion to have a little bit of integrity. You know, it's okay to have a little bite to it, you know? So that's why I did it that way. Now, I'm just adding the rest of my dry ingredients to it. You know, super simple, you know, then, you know, okay, last but not least, you're gonna add that minced garlic. You know, and then as long as you have it in there with everything else, as far as like your spices, and it's on top and moving around on a medium high heat, and I did reduce my heat down to medium, you'll be okay. You don't have to worry about burning it. Now you can see the color of the ground beef, you know, turning. That right there is that chili powder and everything, and you're getting everything mixed up. Now what you want to do is you just want to cook it. I cooked it for about 3 or 4 minutes, you know, and just let it simmer on its own. After that, then I come with my, you know, my Rotel. Look, that's my diced onions and green chilies. You know what, just go ahead and start adding that. You wanna put your tomato sauce, then we're gonna come with our kidney beans. Hey, just super simple. You know, just a no-brainer. This is a one-pot meal, excellent for that busy person that got that schedule. Even if you didn't pre-plan and you forgot, you could just come in and make this and, you know, not, you know, be tied up over the stove all day. Nothing wrong with having that. And then here you see me adding that last can, which is our black beans. And then what you wanna do is you just wanna go ahead and mix it up. And once you got it all mixed, listen, we want to let it simmer. We're going to let it simmer for about 15 to 20 minutes. And here's the key. You'll notice that I never put a lid on top, which I have a lid for that cast iron skillet, but I don't use a lid. And the reason I'm not using the lid, you want to go ahead and let any of the liquids that can, any of the steam and all of that, you want that to evaporate because we're going to be adding that chili on top and we don't want all of that liquid. You want it to still have some integrity so it'll stand up like a brick. Now, this right here is key. I talk about it in all my videos. You gotta taste in stages. I tasted it, and now I know it's time to hit it with a little bit of salt. I went ahead and put two generous pinches of salt, and then I ground myself some pepper on that. Then I'm gonna stir it up, and then I'm gonna taste it again. That's key, you guys. This is so when you're done, you're not seasoning at the end. When you season now, listen, you cooking that great taste inside, you know, along with that simmering process, and this right here is what's gonna separate you from the rest of everybody else that don't do that. So that's key. Now, got it all mixed up. Now I'm gonna taste it again and boom, there you have it. And right here, I'm just like smoothing it out. I know that I'm gonna go ahead and just let this continue to simmer. Remember, 15 to 20 minutes is what you need. And then you can look and see how it comes out. Now, cornbread. No need to show cornbread. Listen, it's up to you. If you want to make it extremely fast, you could just use box cornbread, whatever it is. It's something that you like, and you're going to put it on top of this chili. I'm going to stand behind this chili right here. You're going to love it. So listen, cornbread and this chili, hands down, that's it. Now, the cream corn. Now, I put the cream corn in there. That's about a half a cup. I could have put the whole complete can in there. It's really up to you. This right here is to my liking, and everybody here, that's what we like. You know, about that much corn in there. So right now, I just want you to see like the texture. That's why I'm picking it up, letting it fall so you can see. You get your cornbread batter right, and then once you add that cream corn, or you can use whole corn, whole sweet corn. It's up to you. Or you can just no corn at all. When I tell you this recipe right here is flexible, it's flexible. And there you can see a lot of that liquid has like evaporated. You know, we done cooked it down. You can see it simmering real good. Hey, your mouth should be watering. If it's not, something is wrong. All right, so after we do this, we're gonna mix it all up. We're gonna reduce that heat. You know what I mean? We wanna get it, you know, matter of fact, now would be the time to go ahead and just cut your heat off. You know, just go ahead and turn your fire off. And then what we wanna do is we wanna smooth it out. Now you'll see I take that spoon and I run it around the edges just to get an indentation all the way around, you know, on the edge, because we want to put about 16 ounces of that cornbread on top. And that's about all it's going to be able to handle with these ingredients and this cornbread without overflowing. Super easy, you guys. Now, once I'm done with that, then you go ahead and get that cornbread. And this is the easy part. You can't get this wrong right here. You can actually pour it all in the center. I like to try to pour it as evenly as possible. And now you want to, after you get that done, you take a spatula or you can use the back end of a spoon and just make sure you got it coated. If some areas are thicker than the other, you just want to move it around. You just want to get an even coat. And then you want to put it in the oven, which should have been preheated at 375 degrees. And you put it in the oven for about 40 minutes. And this is what you come up with right here. Check it with a toothpick. If the toothpick is dry, boom, you in the game. Then go ahead and use whatever utensil you would like, you know, to go ahead and take it out. This right here, hey, I just want to tell you, have a pillow because you're going to get the itis. Hey, thank you guys for watching. Now you have a cornbread chili pie. Enjoy, you guys. So tell me what you guys think about this one here. Super easy to make, you know, and I want to tell you guys, listen, it's really not about like the cornbread. This recipe right here is more so you can have like some other options, you know, so you can put this in instead of having like a weekly rotation or maybe even 2 weeks. Now we're starting to stretch it out to like about 3 weeks. So super easy. You guys got some room. It's flexible. You can do your own cornbread. You can use Jiffy. You can use some of my cornbread recipes, whatever you use. Try this. I promise you everybody gonna love it. Hey, and have a pillow around you, because listen, you're gonna be ready to go to bed. Now, listen, if you're new to my channel, let me go ahead and take this time to say, hey, thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and tell everybody out there, there's a channel out here that's simplifying these recipes and taking the mystery out of cooking. And you guys know how I'm about to end this one. I'm out of here. Peace.